idea came from my great friendship and love for Carol.
Does he know you're Harriet Barrett and that I found you
the
first?
Does he know that you're Carol Daly?
He probably does.
The instructions were really simple. Take the canvas, know that it's a gift, make something that you want. There were no restrictions other than it needed to be done on this.
I've loved your mother for a lot of years. She's been a friend of mine for a lot of years. She's been very supportive. She's bought some of my work. She's a collector.
Carol is full of color. And so I love to do abstract because it's alive, it's bright, it has energy, and that's what I think about Carol. She has all those wonderful elements.
First, I want to say that I have been long time very delighted in knowing Carol, because Carol is one of those people who really know and admire art.
Good to see you.
I'm so glad I'm still here.
I know, I am too.
First thing that comes to my mind, and the thing that I love the most about her, is that she is totally outrageous. She can make fun of herself. She has a sense of humor. She is fair. She's loyal. She's passionate. She's a wonderful friend. And she thinks out of the box.
I'm thinking right now in Minnesota, and it's fall, and the leaves are on the ground. And they were first buds created by nature, and then they were leaves. And now they died, and they're down on the ground going back to nature. So I decided to select this image, which is not traditionally mine, to talk about that cyclical existence of us, so that I wouldn't be terribly sad about Carol leaving without thinking that she's going to be coming back.
My hope is that people will put them in their homes on a place where they can see it often. And when they see art, they will think of Carol. They will be reminded of the fact that she really believed that art changes lives.
I'm a photographer that's always, for the last two decades, committed my work to social justice. So I picked four areas that I thought explained and complimented Carol on her commitment to social justice, human rights, and people whose lives have been marginalized. And they are the homeless, physically challenged, refugees, and battered women shelters.
Well, when I think of Carol, I think of life. She has been so generous with her spirit and so funny and always a smile. And when she's serious, she can be very serious. And so I think of her as one of the most living people, and she will live on. So she's not really going away. This blue bird flying over a landscape was the one that's the most significant about how I feel.
She is certainly one of the most positive people that I've ever known in my life.
Carol has always been bigger than life.
Energetic, sometimes difficult, most of the times wonderful, funny, so appreciative, so alive.
I guess I wrote her a note one time about how she basically taught us how to live, and now she's teaching us how to die.
This is an incredible gift that only this person could have created.
Aha.
I couldn't remember. Oh, there's dear Elizabeth dressed for Halloween.
Carol is pretty magical, because she brings light. And I mean that in several ways. I mean, she brings light
of perception, intelligence, and knowing, but she brings light of laughter and compassion and humor that is rare in this world.
Has she ever told you that her favorite visual is light on water?
No, she never told me, but that's what this is. Light on Lake Superior.
What she has done is just remarkable.
It's a wonderful life. You know.
In the sky, also on the faces.
Louis Armstrong.
Of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. I watch them grow. They're like much more than I ever knew. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself.
And of course, now I want to speak.
What a wonderful world.